So the week just passed has seen the Emmys with some great success for Jewish actors and actresses, obviously over in America, but watched over here in Australia and all over the Western world. Amy Schumer, who's clearly got a Jewish surname there, but does she really want to be recognized as a Jew? Let's just find out.
Yes. Yes. How did you grow? You're a Jewish girl? Jewish-ish.
Jewish-ish.
What's
Jewish-ish? Like, my mom is Protestant. I had a bat mitzvah, but that's the last time I was in temple.
So I guess with a Protestant mom, probably not easily identified as being Jewish. But, you know, sometimes you can be Jewish and it can be really quite valuable, particularly in that sort of industry.
Oh, really? Yeah. So you're not Jewish? Do Jewish people claim you? That's when you know if you're Jewish or not. Do they claim you?
Yeah. Oh, I amp it up when I'm in LA in meetings. Okay. When I'm meeting. When someone's like, hey, I'm Josh Katz. I'm like, oh my God. I Jew it up for real. But I feel more Jewish than anything else. But I'm not religious.
Jewing it up. I suppose that's what I'm doing right now, isn't it? You know, Jewing it up. Well, yeah, she's doing it for commercial advantage. And she probably doesn't have the sort of credentials that I have, but nevertheless, I think it's great to see that people can use their Jewishness of sorts to all advantages. And Jeffrey Tambor, who's just also been awarded an Emmy for his role in Transparent, he certainly has taken being Jewish to a completely different level. He's telling the story of a Jewish family who are experiencing changes of extraordinary proportions.
So I have something to tell you.
Oh my God. I have to tell him.
No.
Yes.
Allie's crazy.
Tell me what?
Dad is a woman.
Does mom know?
Of course I know that. You think I'm a dummy?
It's his thing. It's his little private kink. Everyone has one. Right, Rabbi?
Well, I guess everyone has, you know, one or two.
The reason that I feel so strong.
I have three kids. I can't live without them.
So if, like me, you haven't had a chance to catch this story, it's actually out on Amazon, which is a different way of watching television these days. You go online. And he basically plays a character who is feeling like a woman. You know, the transgender issue is very contemporary, and it's now being explored in a Jewish family setting where there are lesbian daughters and also issues which, you know, often you would not see explored in day-to-day life. We hide away from them. We altogether have done for many years. But it's just a sign of the times. And apparently being received by the wider community in America really, really well.
Because we come from shtetl people. Your grandma Rose actually ate lettuce with her bare hands.
Another great TV series that I don't think was recognized at the Emmys, but certainly will be in the future, was Grace and Frankie. There's a Jewish connection here because the Goldbergs, who are in business with another family, a non-Jewish family, are basically going to go through a really strange experience. The two males are going to become partners in real life as well as in business. And the two wives of those partners, it's complicated, isn't it? Look, the reality is, you got to watch it. It's on Netflix. It is probably some of the best written American comedy I've seen in a long time. And of course, it has its poignant moments as well.
We want to talk to you about something. Saul and I are in love.
Excuse me?
You're gay.
We want to get married.
Oh, married?
Because we can do that now.
I know. I hosted that fundraiser. Well, I don't
know why. I'm heartbroken.
One of the stories which certainly isn't receiving worldwide attention is the role that Israel's playing in the plight of Syrian refugees. We have a hospital in Safat that is regularly treating, and has been for the last 2 years, Syrians who are escaping from all sorts of dreadful situations in their own country. Children, men, women, there's no prejudice in Israeli hospitals, and certainly from all accounts it would seem that the Syrian refugees are receiving the most extraordinary attention. Who can forget the Pope's visit to Israel last year, where he met one president, and this year he meets another president in the United States. last week we talked about the pilgrimage which many Jews make to Uman in recognition of Reb Nachman, who is buried there. And one such pilgrim sadly didn't come home to Israel. Amir Shlomo Ohana apparently passed away as a result of falling into a lake, possibly from a heart attack. We're not quite sure. But the reality is that one out of 30,000 really didn't expect that pilgrimage to end that way. And yet, who could forget what's going on over in Saudi Arabia this week, where we've seen the most amazing scenes of worship and yet extraordinary tragedy. And we do so often see it when so many people come together, but over 700 people being killed and many, many, many hundreds more injured. This was a true tragedy of extraordinary proportions. Another curious thing I saw this week was a meeting between Bibi Netanyahu and Vladimir Putin, who together shake hands on some sort of strange deal to not to fire on each other as they sit. The Russians sit in Syria's borders, and that clearly means that there could be flypies across each other's airspace. Well, we've agreed as Israel not to fire on the Russians, and the Russians have agreed not to fire on us. I mean, that's something of a truce or some sort of a bipartisan agreement, I think. I'm not sure it's a bad thing to have a good relationship with Vladimir Putin. He's a pretty scary character. And finally, it's time to party. Party like it's the end of a very long year of reading the Sefer Torah, the five books of Moses. We're finally through the High Holy Days. We're coming up to Simchas Torah, and it's time to shake off all your dancing shoes and get out on the streets and synagogues and truly dance your heart out. And we do this in great style all over the world. We may be in Israel, where we center around the squares of perhaps Tel Aviv or Netanya. We may even be in India, where there is a Jewish community flourishing as well. Of course, in California, there's plenty of shuls, plenty of partying going on there. But there's partying going on right here in Melbourne. And believe it or not, it's not just the religious Jews that get to enjoy a real party. It's also the not so religious down in Temple, and here's a piece from last year. I'm sure they'll be doing just as good this year. Have a great week. Sweet as honey, sweet as honey, sweet as honey on our tongue. Sweet as honey, sweet as honey, sweet as honey on our tongue. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu. Time.